legs crossed, back straight, eyes closed. Breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. Deep, long breaths in through your nose and out through your mouth. Feel that power of you controlling your breathing. Power that's available to you all the time, wherever you are in life.
First time, he scores a near post.
Close your eyes.
Hi again, everyone. We are on the final page of Satguru's wisdom and sharing his top 10 rules for success. And my favorite one, or one of my favorites, is number 10, which is always do your best. It's really simple. You hear it all the time, either from our parents, from family members, friends, teachers. Always do your best. It is not easy to do, because in a moment when we've made a mistake, we tend to dwell on the fact that we experienced a sense of loss. Let's free ourselves from that by falling in love with the process of what we're trying to create. We're trying to create our best self. That is the business that is our responsibility. It's the business of living. So as we go on this path from going from mind power to mind wealth, let's be freed by the fact that we're all going to make lots of mistakes. But if we're doing our best each and every moment to learn from every decision, then we're already there. We're in that process. Have a great day, everybody.
I really look forward to being with you every month. And this is such an exciting one for me to do because I've had all month to think about what do I want to share when it comes to being calm. So here's what we're going to do today. I'm going to go through habits to help you be financially calm and financially productive. So as you all know, my expertise is personal finance. I like to help you get your finances right so you can live your best life. And I know that when you fix your financial habits, you fix your financial life. So here we go. Number one, it's going to be the most annoying habit. Spend less than you earn. Nothing will create anxiety in your life like consistently spending more money than you make. Nothing. And it is the number one cause of anxiety, stress, and concern in people's lives. It is this constant treadmill of whatever you make, you spend more. Not just whatever you make, you spend, but whatever you make, you spend more. So the fastest way to have a calmer life is to spend less than you make. Now, let me just address, I know that this is not easy for everyone to do, especially now because with inflation, everything is starting to cost more. But before we talk about all the reasons why this is difficult, let's talk about the ways in which you fix these things. First way you fix making sure you spend less than you make is making sure you actually know where you're spending your money. And what you really need to be looking at is here's what happens in the real world. And I know I'm saying something I've said before on this one, but what happens in the real world is people, it's the weirdest phenomenon. People round up in their mind what they earn. If a person makes $76,780 a year, and you ask that person, like Michelle Anderson, I said, hi, Michelle. If I said to Michelle, what do you make? Michelle would not typically say, I make $76,870 a year. That's not her number. I'm just throwing it out as an example. She would say, probably, not picking on you, Michelle, just using you as an example to keep you all awake here like a classroom. She'd say, I make $80,000 a year. In her mind, she would round up the number. It's the most fascinating thing because everyone does this. We round up what our earnings are. And we round down what our expenses are in our mind. And what happens often by rounding up what we earn in our mind and rounding down what we spend is there's a 10 to 20% differential. And that 10 to 20% differential is why people are constantly financially freaking out because the math doesn't work. We got a brand new day.
And I say no. They say what you doing, trying to do somebody cold. I just let the music come from my soul, so all of my people can stay on the floor. They got a brand new dance. You gotta move your muscles. A brand new dance. It's called a Cupid Shuffle. It don't matter if you're young or you're old.
Here we go.
We gon' show you how it goes.
Now walk it by yourself. Now you see what I'm
Good morning, everybody. I want us to look at ourselves today in a different way. And from here on in, I want us to think of ourselves each and every moment as being the CEO of our own lives. So you are the chief executive officer of your life. Your life is your business. It is your brand. It is you. It is the truest and most deepest and greatest part of you. So how do we go on this path together from going from mind power to mind wealth, and that mind wealth can create that freedom and happiness that we desire in any form? We look at every decision as a CEO's decision. So every decision you make, your job is to respond to the positive thoughts, to fill your mind up with as much positive energy as possible, because positive equals profits. That's the way I want you to look at it. Negative responses equal losses. Have a great day, everybody.
Most of this generation quits the second they get talked to. You did this wrong, you did this wrong. It's so easy to be great nowadays. Most people are weak. This is a softened generation. So if you have any mental toughness, any ability, if you have any fraction of self-discipline, the ability to not want to do it, but still do it. People have a hard thing to understand. I hate to run. And what makes me so crazy, people go, well, why do you run if you hate it? What are you talking about? I don't want to take showers and eat either. I hate that too. That's life, man. It wasn't until I changed that mentality that I became somebody. I hated going to school, so guess what? I was dumb as shit. One plus one is two. But if you can get through to doing things that you hate to do, on the other side is greatness. That's what people understand. By me running, I am callous in my mind. I'm not training for a race. I'm training for life. I'm training for the time when I get that 2 o'clock in the morning call that my mom is dead or something happens tragic in life. I don't fall apart.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and I make these videos because when I started my first business, I really struggled to believe in myself. I was making $300 a month and quit on my business partner. And the thing that saved me was watching the stories of successful entrepreneurs. They gave me strategies as well as hope and belief that just maybe I could do it myself as well. And I hope that this video here today helps you get a little bit more belief in yourself, because I still need the videos for myself today too. So today, let's learn what you need to start doing for a successful life. Enjoy.
I'm training my mind and my body and my spirit so it's all one, so I can handle what life is going to throw at me. Because the life I've lived, it throws a whole bunch at you. And if you're not physically and mentally prepared for that, you're just going to crumble and you're good for nobody. You said, I can be me. The second you said, I can cuss and be me. And cussing, people, I said, man, you cuss all the time. Why? Well, I hate to say it. The best way for me to get how I feel across, I can't sit here and say, you know what? Yeah, I went through Hell Week and man, it was really hard. No, that motherfucker takes your damn soul, rips it inside out. And then they say, now we're going to start. It allows me to express where I was at a point of my life. If I don't give you all of me, why the hell am I here? Why? How will you learn from me? People take so much offense to me. You will never learn from people if we always tap dance around the truth.
Oh, God, I love that.
We tap dance around the truth by finding the right words so I don't hurt you because you have thin skin. No. Tighten up, people. It's okay. Trust me. It's okay. You might be called nigger one day. It's okay. You might be called some Jewish word or some or gay word. It's okay. Let them call you that. What are you going to do now? They don't own your life. How are you going to control that now? How are you going to flip it upside down and say, Roger that. Now I'm going to harness and you'll read about me years from now.
Rule number two is flip your money with Grant Cardone.
So if someone's got between 1,000 and 10,000 and they're trying to multiply it to 100,000, what would be the steps they would take? How long do you think it would take them to go from 1,000 or 10,000 to multiply it? And would you say put that all in your own personal investment? Would you invest in the business that you're in? Would you invest it in other things that cash flow, appreciate, and provide tax shelters? What would you do?
If you got $1,000, I would like just keep investing in yourself until you got another 1,000.
Okay.
And then invest in yourself, now you got 2,000 invested in, you go, you should start making money faster.
Mm-hmm.
At some point you should start, like, every time you make an investment in yourself, if I put fuel in my car, it's supposed to take me further.
Right.
Right. So if I invest in myself, then, and look, there's things I bought that I didn't get a return on right away. But I didn't quit investing in a course or a workshop or training or education mm-hmm. because it didn't work.
Or your health. Or
I spent 17 years going to school. None of it was any good for me.
Mm-hmm.
But it did teach me. It did teach me how to go to school.
Right.
You know?
How to study.
How to study, how to go there, how to complete a course. Like I completed college. Mm-hmm. I'm not proud of that, by the way.
You're not proud you completed it? Why
no,
not?
No, because it was stupid. It was ridiculous. I should have dropped out. Like I knew it was a bad thing.
What'd you major in?
Majored in accounting. It's a good degree. It's not like just some, business degree.
Right. But you should have dropped out of it. Why?
I should 100% because I'd have a 5-year jump on my career.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is I was on drugs. So.
Actual drugs?
If I wouldn't have been on drugs, I would have quit college. Because I would have had enough confidence in myself.
Mm.
When you're on drugs, you can't have confidence. Because you know you're drugged.
Right.
So everything is second guess. Because my self-esteem was like through the basement. And so I'm like, I need to quit college. But everybody around me is, oh, no, you got to finish college. You got to finish college. I'm like, what do I know? I'm a drug addict.
Mm-hmm. And if I drop out, I don't have a degree, and then he's gonna hire me.
I didn't even worry about any of that because, I didn't worry about that. I just didn't have the confidence to follow my intuition. You can't when you're
on drugs,
when you're not yourself. So what do you do with $1,000, right?
Right.
I think you just got to keep investing in you until now I'm making $3,000.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, boom, reinvest all that again. But what we do is we start taking it off the table, right?
We save it, we don't invest it.
So I think people just need to get on that cycle of like, okay, I'm gonna keep repeating this activity. I'm gonna reinvest some money in myself, go to the workshop or whatever. Mm-hmm. Monday, I gotta be hustling again.
Under the lights, and everything goes. But when I hurt, then I'm getting you close.
physical. It's in the air, it's in my blood, it's rushing on. I don't need no reason, don't need control. I fly so high, no ceiling when I'm in my zone. Cause I got that sunshine in my pocket, got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it, moving so phenomenally. Come on, like the way we rock it, so don't stop, stop, stop. Under the lights, and everything goes. But where I have been, I'm getting you close. And we move where you already know. So just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feeling good, good, creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance. Come on. All those things I shouldn't do, but you dance.
Good morning, Believe Nation and Determination. Yesterday, we looked at you as being the CEO of your life, making decisions that will propel you towards your infinite mind wealth. Today, I want us to look at ourselves as player one in the ultimate game, the mind game. And how do we win the mind game? Because once we do, we can have anything we can ever dream of or desire. We have to realize we are a magnet. So you're in this game today and each and every day. You are a magnet and you have the two greatest weapons. You have believe, you have determination. Those two things are weapons that you use to attract all positive things. So all positive thoughts. You do this over and over in the game and eventually you will suffocate all the negative thought space that's in your mind and win the mind game. Have a great day, everybody.
Most of the time, there is a voice in your head that comments and has opinions and viewpoints and interpretations about what's going on in your life. I call that the voice in the head. For most humans, that is completely involuntary. They don't even know that they have a voice in the head that never stops talking. Most of the time, silently in your head. At other times, it may even shout something out, so it wants to be heard. If you walk in the street, you will find most people look fairly sane. They're not talking to themselves, it seems, because they're not talking out aloud. But if you listened into everybody's head, you would be amazed of how noisy the inside of every human is. It's like a radio, you know, these radio stations where the people talk in an excited voice. If you go to a foreign country and you don't know what they're talking about, you might think this must be extremely important. But if you can understand what they're saying, you realize it's completely meaningless. It's just noise.
Need motivation?
Watch a top 10 with Believe Nation.
Hey, it's Evan Carmichael, and I make these videos because in my first business, I struggled to stay afloat. I quit on my business partner, and the thing that kept me motivated, that kept me going, was studying the stories of famous, successful entrepreneurs. And in their stories, it gave me the hope, the drive, the ambition, the thinking that maybe I can do it too, that extra bit of belief. And I still need their stories today, and I'm honored to share them with you here as well. So today, let's learn from one of the best, Eckhart Tolle, and my take on his top 10 rules of success. Enjoy.
So a significant part of what happens in your mind, the larger part, is actually just superfluous noise. Thinking is a wonderful ability, a wonderful tool. If used rightly, it is an instrument that causes dysfunction and misery for millions on the planet, unhappiness for millions on the planet, if thinking is not used, but if you are used by thought. So when humans say, "I think," in most cases, that's actually not true because they have no control over their thinking. It's a compulsive and involuntary. And they are so identified with these thought processes, they don't even know that they are in the grip of their thought processes because they are so identified, they become their thought processes. So whatever comes into your head, you completely believe in it, and then you, yeah, that's how it is. Whenever you feel unhappiness, this is a generic term, unhappiness in whatever form. Unhappiness can arise as irritation, can arise as anger, can arise as even boredom is a form of unhappiness, sadness, all kinds of states that are not, they don't feel pleasant, it's unhappiness. And usually they are attributed to a life situation, something that's going on in your life. So, for example, waiting at the airline counter, and of course, how often things don't go well there.
That oneness, that consciousness, that awareness. That we know is in all of us.